Local government and organized as an important instrument for enhancing the process through stimulate and sustain the tempo of development at that level. The failure of the country to make appreciable progress has been attributed to the inability to build a sound institutional framework that will effectively harness the potential and bring over 75% of the people in that area to the mainstream of the overall development process.
The Royal Highnesses, Emirs and Chiefs, Chairman, appointed Chairman and members of the Local Women Catholic Authority, on your well deserved appointment, voted in the past, but the various notable reforms were undermined, while the image and the reputation of the local government system and its operators were also brought to effect and the ability to perform. And therefore, I challenge you to play your part with absolute determination to testing, reminding that efficient service delivery and the attainment of developmental goals can only be achieved if members of the caretaker committees work together harmoniously among themselves and relate to the other groups, particularly the professional career officials and other agencies as partners in the program. As the expectations and the needs of your local communities are numerous, you should do everything possible as members of the Caretaker Committee to reawaken the latent communal spirit in your people by getting them meaningfully involved in the design and execution of development programs through the promotion and intensification of self-help programs. In the face of competing demands against scarce and dwindling resources, absolutely necessary for members of the Caretaker Committee to prioritize their program with a view to concentrate only on those projects that will benefit the greatest number of their people. We cannot afford to spread your scarce resources too thin, otherwise we may have nothing to show at the end of the day. The need for members of the Caretaker Committee to be fair and firm in dealing with their people, as well as to be committed to rendering selfless service to their communities, cannot be overemphasized. For the effective performance of their duties and their responsibilities, you are advised to establish in your respective local government an effective feedback mechanism which will enable you to examine and monitor your actions with a view to improving your performance. Launch the orientation workshop. Thank you.
Today at the opening of this important national orientation workshop for the newly appointed chairman and members of the local government caretaker committees. As you are quite aware, the need to appoint caretaker committees to run the affairs of local government councils was informed by the desire of government to ensure continuity in the effective management of local government administration. Now that this exercise is over, let me seize the opportunity to congratulate all the members of these committees on their appointment, provided first-line services to the generality of our citizens. The standard of living of millions of Nigerians, both in the rural and urban areas, is inevitably affected by local government activities through the provision of their basic needs such as water, good feeder routes, primary health care services, and primary education. Local governments also remain the focal point for the promotion of development and cultural revival through community development projects, which entail the mobilization of human and material resources for the betterment of the living conditions of the people. From the foregoing, it is clear that the expectation of the populace from local government administrations is enormous given the resources at your disposal. It is common knowledge that the local government system in our country has had a checkered history. In the last couple of years, local government areas have witnessed a catalogue of deteriorating social services, mismanagement, and unfulfilled promises. Many local governments have left primary school teacher salaries unpaid. A dogmatic pursuit of the new farm administrative and financial autonomy on the part of the political operators at the local government level was allowed to cripple the system. Instances of acute political insensitivity, unresponsiveness to the citizens' needs and aspirations, managerial ineptitude, debilitating power tussles between the legislative and executive arms of local governments, and physical recklessness became prevalent. The cumulative effect was the dismal failure of the dissolved local government councils to provide essential services or execute meaningful programs for their communities. These actions are in sharp contrast to the spirit and logic behind the various reform measures taken by successive governments over the years. These measures range from the 1976 local government reforms to the 1988 reforms, which guaranteed improved administrative and financial autonomy by abolishing the state ministries of local government. Most importantly, accountability. This government will not tolerate the financial recklessness and managerial incompetence.